The next important discussion which we need to have is about quadratic equations and how we can use quadratic equation as parallel to a coordinate geometry parabola. Okay, so let's try and understand a little bit about quadratic equations before we can draw a parallel about quadratic equations into a parabola. Just like how linear equations were equated to lines, we can equate quadratic equations or even expressions or functions to a parabola. Okay, how linear equations or first degree equations can be equated to a line, similarly quadratic equations, expressions or functions which are second degree equations can be equated to a parabola. Is that clear? Now that is going to be a tremendous way of solving a lot of algebra questions. Okay, if you're able to relate a lot of quadratic equations or expressions into coordinate geometry, you'll be able to derive solutions much quickly. Okay, so let's try and understand the entire implication with this. So let's look at a quadratic equation, ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, now this can be written as a function of x, right? So as I change the values of x, I'm going to get some value for this entire expression. Okay, so I can call that as y. Is that clear? So y is nothing but an outcome. For every value of x I input here, I'm going to get a value of y coming through. Is that clear? Now that is also called as the function of the function of x, or this entire value which is equal to y is also called as the value of the function. Is that clear? Got it? So as and when I substitute different values of x, I'm going to be getting values of y coming through, which is nothing but the value of the function, right? So when they ask you to solve a quadratic equation, what are they basically doing is this. So what is solving a quadratic equation? I have ax square plus bx plus c. When you have to solve a quadratic equation, I'm equating this equation to zero. That means I'm indirectly telling that the value of y is zero and asking you to find the two values of x when value of y is zero. Is that clear? So basically solving a quadratic equation is nothing but asking you to find the value of x when y is zero. Is that clear? Got it? So solving a quadratic equation is nothing but finding the values of x when y is 0. Now let's take this further and map it across to a coordinate geometry curve. So whenever you have a quadratic equation, it is nothing but equal to a parabola. Why is a quadratic equation equal to a parabola? Simple. For every value of y, you are going to be getting two values of x. And that's the reason a quadratic equation gets converted into a parabola. Is that clear? Don't you observe? For every value of y, as the values of y change along the y coordinate axis, there are going to be two different values of x. Okay, for example, when y is 1, x will be 3.2. Okay, and similarly, when y is 1, x is going to be minus 2.25. So for a single value of y, you're going to have two different values of x coming through. Is that clear? So when y is 1, you also have the value of x as 3.2. And when y is 1, you also have the value of x as minus 2.25. Is that clear? So basically for every value of y, you're getting two different values of x. That's the reason a quadratic equation gets transformed into a parabola in the coordinate geometry plane. Is that clear? So a quadratic equation gets transformed into a parabola in a coordinate geometry plane, right? So when y is equal to 0, if I am asked to find the value of x, don't you think in geometric terms, I want to know the value of x when y is 0. So when y is 0, I want to know the value of x here and here. That's nothing but asking you to find out the x-intercept for this particular curve. or this particular graph. Okay, so solving a quadratic equation is nothing but finding the x-intercept of a parabola represented by the same quadratic equation. Is that clear? So solving a quadratic equation is nothing but finding, let's put it in this way, solving a quadratic equation is nothing but finding value of x when y is 0, or in other words, finding the x-intercepts. Okay, finding the x-intercept. Finding the x-intercept is as good as telling finding the values of x when y is equal to 0. Is that clear? So let's quickly summarize whatever we learned over here. Any quadratic equation can be drawn parallel to a parabola in a coordinate geometry plane. Why? Because a quadratic equation by default, for every value of y, you're going to have two values of x. So when y is equal to 0, there are going to be two values or two roots of x coming through. Is that clear? Got it? So that's the reason for every value of y, you're going to have two values of x. Hence, a quadratic equation gets transformed into a parabola in the coordinate geometry plane. Is that clear? Now, in algebraic sense, when you solve a quadratic equation, what are you doing? You're equating the entire quadratic equation to 0 and finding out the roots of the quadratic equation. So in geometric sense, what does it translate? Basically, when y is 0, okay, when y is 0, you're trying and finding out the values of x. Or in other words, the roots of a quadratic equation is nothing but the x-intercepts of this particular curve. It is a place where this curve cuts the x-axis, and that will have two places where it cuts the x-axis. Therefore, that becomes the root of the quadratic equation, or the value of x at these two points will become the two x-intercept values, which will come across as the roots of this equation. Is that clear? So that is the entire understanding or the connection between a parabola and a quadratic equation, right? Now, with this idea in mind, let's move on to understand a couple of more important things, okay?